We're talking gusty winds, at times heavy rainfall, peak wind gusts up to 60 miles an hour will be possible. That's primarily through the afternoon and evening. So we certainly could see some power outages, flooding, maybe some difficult travel in there as well. So use some caution with your plans as you're heading on out for your Friday. This is a look at that storm system now. Again, been downgraded to a tropical storm with the National Hurricane Center update at 5 a.m. this morning. Just before that was still a Category 1 hurricane. The center of that storm still moving through Georgia. Those outer rain bands are heavily impacting the Carolinas, especially South Carolina, where we've had numerous tornado warnings so far this morning. We have additional moisture out ahead of this storm system that's moved into Indiana this morning, and so we are tracking this in waves for us here. Currently, Tropical Storm Helene has wind speeds at 70 miles per hour and is moving north at 30 miles per hour. Makes a northwesterly turn as we head through the day. And then through the weekend, it just kind of stalls out here, and it's going to linger in the region and continue to bring us rainfall as we head through the next couple of days. Primary impacts, though, come today. At this time, Forum Life Guardian radar does have rain that has moved through much of central Indiana with just some steady light rainfall at this time. So if you're out getting ready to head for that morning commute, expect those interstates to be wet, very wet around the 465 this morning. We saw some pockets of some just slightly heavier showers down to the south, Lawrence County, Jackson County, but nothing that is too terribly heavy at this time. We'll have better chances for that as we get later into the day with the second wave. So this first wave, some light, steady rainfall continues on through the late morning, and then as we get towards noon, I think much of this starts to ease, scatters a good bit, and here comes the second wave from the remnants of Helene, and this takes us to 4 p.m. This is when I think we have a better chance to see some pockets of some heavier showers. Again, steady rainfall for a few hours from the afternoon into the evening. Then I say by about 7-8 o'clock, this scatters. So that's good news as far as if you did have plans tonight. I'm not expecting widespread steady rainfall all night long. You might be afforded some dry opportunities, but the problem is we're still dealing with wind, which is a major part of the story for today, where we have a wind advisory and a high wind warning. That's here. And those oranger colors, those darker colors, that continues on starting from noon until 1 a.m. tomorrow morning. Winds gusting up to 60 miles an hour possible. At this time, they're close to 30 mile an hour wind gusts. I'd say they're going to reach their peak, really pick up in intensity between about 2 and 9 o'clock later on this afternoon and evening. And then as we head through the overnight hours, we still stay breezy, but those winds do die down. Today, temperatures on the cooler side. Mid-60s is where we are now. Highs in the low 70s. And then as we head through the weekend, we're going to keep scattered rainfall as we head through Saturday and Sunday. So there will be some dry time. Most of the rain is going to be concentrated in our southern counties, but we will see some of that extended north too. That will be the case Saturday and Sunday, so off and on showers through the weekend, still pretty breezy on Saturday. And then as we get into Monday and Tuesday, we keep those widely scattered showers around, so unsettled, highs in the mid and upper 70s, more sunshine and quieter weather though as we get into the middle of next week.